While mouse and keyboard are most PC gamers' preferred interface methods, many enjoy gaming on the controller of their liking. With the Steam Deck, you don't have much choice when you're on the move, so what happens when your deck develops the dreaded stick drift? Hang tight and I'll explain what's happening and how to fix it. Stick drift, what is it? Well, it's what happens when you're not moving the analog input stick at all, but your game is responding like you are. I had this recently with my PlayStation 4 controller and now with my Steam Deck. The same thing happened on both. You see, inside the controller, or Steam Deck in this instance, are X and Y axis measurement points on a rocker. These transmit the stick positions to the system and the game to tell it what you want. But those stock ones are potentiometer-style sensors which use friction and will wear over time. And that's basically where I'm at with my Steam Deck. I told y'all, I use this thing a lot, remember? So, how do you fix it? Replacement gimbals or sticks, of course, and that's just what I plan to do. You could take apart the gimbal sensors and clean and recenter them, but that's hopium at best. You want to do what I'm doing and replace them with some Hall Effect sensor gimbals. These use magnets and sensors so there are no moving parts to wear out or get out of whack. These are essentially the same thing that professional drone racing pilots use in their transmitters, but in your Steam Deck. So, let's get the old ones out and the new ones in to see if it keeps me alive longer in dead cells before I hit the road again. Alright folks, with the Steam Deck off, because you don't want to do this while it's powered up, have your gimbals ready, have yourself a spudger, definitely need something to pop it apart with, a pair of tweezers just to be kit safe, and a small Phillips head screwdriver. This is one from my drone kit. It's tiny, magnetized, makes this super easy. So what you want to do is flip it over. I highly recommend holding on to the Steam Deck case to help you with this. So go ahead, set it down. All right, see there? Now we flip it over, and you got to get the screws out. You got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Take those out. And I forgot these two, so shame on me. So it's actually 8 screws in total. So once you've got that apart, you need to break the, and it sounds so violent, but you need to pull the back case off. We're going to pull the memory card just again, be on the safe side. Keep things out of the way that really don't need to be. Let's see. Trying to find a good spot to get in here and get started. There we go. Oh, that sounds so horrible. Let's see, there we go. And just like that, the back is off. All right, so this is the right stick module, and you can see the new one has R on it to make that super simple. But the way you wanna do this is you wanna get your little tweezers and your little screwdriver. You're going to come in here and you're going to pop this little black tab up. You don't have to be crazy with it. It just barely comes up. And then you can take your tweezers and pull your little ribbon cable out. So let's go ahead and take my little bitty screw here. Again, let's see, I'm going to use my tweezers to pick my screws up because they're really small. And doing this on camera is a little nerve-wracking rather than just doing it one piece at a time and coming back around to it. So if you've ever done something like this, you'll know what I mean. All right, so there we go. There is the control stick is, boom, push it right out. All right, so once you've got it out, you're gonna wanna take the old stick off and it just pulls right off. Now I will have to desolder this and solder it to the new board. So have you ever done any soldering? You can do it without it. This is the touch sensitive thing. You can do it without it if you don't want to solder it. So what I'm about to do is pretty advanced, okay? So let's move over to my solder station and I can show you how to do that. Okay, so don't mind the mess here, but we're over here at my soldering station and I have my iron and I have this here ready to go. So what I want to do is, if you're doing this step, which mind you, it is completely up to you whether you want to go through it or not. I'm going to put some flux on that, a little flux pen, that'll get that ready to be heated up and good to go. This is just a feature, again, that the Steam Deck has that if you want to take advantage of the touch sense where it's sensitive to your fingers touching the sticks, you can operate just fine without this.
But I just wanted to go through the process for those who may want to do this. Alright, so there we go. We got that disconnected from the old one. Let's move the new one over here. I can't reiterate enough that this is purely optional. And if you don't have a soldering iron and you want to upgrade this, that's fine. You do not have to do this part. Alright, so from this point you can take your new and ready to go one, drop it right back in. I'm going to move this little wire just out of the way, and there we go. Now all I got to do is put my little screws back in and rinse and repeat for the left stick. Now that you've got the screws all back in, do not forget to reconnect this ribbon cable, or else it's going to be really hard to get it to do anything. You're going to think you didn't do it right or it was broken, but truth is, this ribbon cable isn't in place. It's not connected. With that latched down, let's move on to the left side and just rinse and repeat, and we'll be done. So once you finish that and you're back into your Steam Deck, you want to go ahead and do a quick calibration on everything to make sure everything's good. So hit your Steam button, go to Settings, go down to Controller. Once you're in Controller, hit the Test Input Devices, pull the left trigger, pull the right trigger, left touchpad, we're going to go across all of the touchpad. Right trackpad, same thing, we're going to do all the right trackpad, you got pressure test. Alright, so it says move the left joystick in a circle, move in a circle, move the right joystick in a circle, and press all remaining buttons. Alright, press everything, hold B to exit, you know, calibration, start testing, test it there, boom, there's your dead space. Alright, stop testing, go to right one, start testing, same thing there. So you got a little bit off. You can recalibrate these with the actual button on there if you want to, but that's how we do it.
Sweet! It works like a charm. But should you do it? I mean, let's be real here. It's only a $30 upgrade, and it's something you may or may not ever have to do. But if you're out of town like I was when the stick drift reared its ugly head, then you might have wished you did it already. The stock sticks feel great, they do, but man, these feel so much smoother. For me, I wish I had done this sooner, but you'll have to make that decision for yourself. The process of doing this was straightforward and simple thanks to the engineering decisions behind the Steam Deck. The upgrade was worth it for me, but I'd love to hear from the rest of you if you've had to deal with stick drift. And if so, what did you do? Most people I know toss a controller, but I'd love to hear if you fixed one like I did in my PlayStation or replaced one like I did with my Steam Deck. Sound off in the comment section below, and while you're down there, make sure you've hit that subscribe button and the bell is rung so that you don't miss more PC hardware and software goodness.